lot of things are being set up for Monday night on Raw. I know tonight is going to be the Elimination Chamber, which I'm not looking forward to. What do they have? Randy Orton, Daniel Bryan, John Cena, Sheamus, Christian, and Cesaro. All fucking around the steel cage. You got the guy who's supposed to be in the main event of WrestleMania, Batista, in a match with Alberto Del Rio. You have Darren Young versus Titus O'Neil. And a loser goes back in the closet match. And why the fuck did I say that? And you got a useless ass tag team match between the Usos and, what's his face? The New Age Outlaws. It took forever for me to remember what they were. It's not that I never care for them, I mean, I do. It's just, I got some crazy brain farts when I'm not in conversation mode. But damn. And you got the IC title match with Big E. It's not Big E Langston no more. They messed up versus Jack Swagger. So you got a decent card, surprisingly. And you take one of those Elimination Chambers out, and it becomes a much more full, much more solid pay-per-view where you have undercard matches like that. That's a good thing. I'm glad we got a Darren Young versus Titus O'Neil. Last time we got something like that was with, in 2011. With The Miz versus Alex Riley, or the year before with JTG versus Shad Gaspard. Of course, we all know what happened after that. All those guys managed to lose a bit of success afterwards, but hopefully that doesn't happen here. Like when pay-per-view matches had undercards with storylines. That needs to be a thing. A lot of these matches of the book just seem otherwise not fun. But none of this except for that seems fun. I'm looking forward to seeing some of the highlights, but yeah. What really matters is that Monday is going to be that whack-ass WWE Netflix network type shit that's going to be released after Raw's done. And more importantly, that Hulk Hogan is going to make his return after 7 years. Yes, 7 years. He's going to return to WWE, which it's about time. Been a minute, and a necessary one at that. And I didn't like seeing him in TNA, but hopefully they give him an okay role in WWE. They don't make him too much of an authoritative guy behind the scenes. They just sign him a de jure role as a general manager or something of that nature. Have him host Mania, that's it. Give him his paychecks. Don't put him in ridiculous storylines with something as asinine as Aces and Eights. And don't put the Aces and Eights in Monday Night Raw. That would be worse than asinine. That would be dubious. How is that worse? That's not sound worse than dubious. I'm just using a bunch of brain police words at this point. Gotta be kidding me. That's really the meat and bones of what I want to talk about. Hulk Hogan. Dude's coming back, and someone else might come back too. It's either Undertaker, or we may see the debut of Sting. I don't know if they finally got him his contract. Sting keeps fucking around with these contracts. He just draws that shit out for a millennium. What's he gonna get to take this? Get this guy signed? I know it shouldn't take TNA much to get Sting signed. They just say, alright, you'll be on TNA, we'll throw some title shots at you, maybe you win some. There you go. Got Sting. What about for WWE? What are they gonna do with him? Nothing. Gonna have a toy deal? You know, be in this match against The Undertaker, you're gonna do this thing and that thing. It's like all this side stuff for them to get some mutual revenue. Maybe a DVD, the best of Sting, with a bunch of WWE guys in the background talking about how their childhood was shaped by Sting or something stupid. Some backstage funnies, you name it, the works. Oh, he was a drug addict at one point, but now he found God. And if it's Undertaker that's coming back too, then you might see some cool stuff, because I generally like these streak storylines now. Like, the one with CM Punk was awesome, where CM Punk was doing some of the best heel work he's ever done. And I like the glare he gave to Undertaker after that awesome-ass old-school match. I love the way the whole thing was set up. And in a morbid way, the stars aligned when Paul Bearer croaked. That last heel run with CM Punk, even though that title run, that 434-day title run, that was enamored with stupid storylines, engulfed by it, marinated by it, CM Punk was doing some brilliant heel work with that faking Jerry Lawler's heart attack, busting him open in that cage match. All that Paul Bearer shit, that match with John Cena where he actually did a pile driver. Crazy. I was feeling it from beginning to end. And he changed his look up when he did that heel turn. So much stuff was awesome about that. I didn't like the Triple H stuff, or Shawn Michaels stuff was okay. I think Shawn Michaels gets into too many crybaby storylines. Like, they were always crying. Like, 05, 06, well, he's not doing that gay show with DX. He had some okay storylines, but now it's all about how he was an icon and shit, and how he's a pass with everybody because he's been there for so long. Come on, cut that shit out. It's annoying. It's annoying as hell. But yeah. Can't wait to see Hogan again where he belongs. I'm glad he's there without his nasty ass daughter. Her nasty ass cooch. Probably hot dog colored too, just like their skin. I'm glad that the nasty ass son ain't there neither, with his nasty ass car accidents and fatalities and drug addictions. Is he dead? I don't know. I really don't know. Or that nasty ass impact zone. Your ass better not make the IC title get a plan C. If people start cashing in their IC to mid-card titles for a WWE title shot, I'm gonna be pissed, Hogan. But other than that, fuck it. I don't like any of you guys. That's just my thoughts on Hogan returning and all the stuff we're looking forward to for Monday. And it's not gonna be the network shit, because I'm not gonna pay for that bum-ass WWE Netflix bullshit. Fuck out of here. Maybe for the ECW shit, maybe for the WCW stuff and the old school WWE shit, but I don't give a fuck about the pay-per-views. Pay-per-views to my dick. Ain't nothing worth seeing for 3 hours. Worth 20 bucks? Nah. Never. Give me that Netflix shit, whack. Mediocre 6 months, bullshit. Don't like it. Mr. Walker 7, I respect the king.